L4-L5 disc herniation, L4-L5 disc bulge, L5-S1 disc herniation, L5-S1 disc bulge. Can chiropractic help or is surgery required? That's the exact question I got asked in one of the comments in my video. And in this episode of Ask Dr. Walter Salubro, I'm going to answer, can chiropractic help a disc herniation in the lumbar spine or a disc bulge, or is surgery required? Now, again, the short answer is yes, chiropractic can help patients with disc bulges or disc herniations in the lumbar spine, whether it's L4-L5 disc bulge, L4-L5 disc herniation, L4-L5 disc protrusion, L5-S1 disc bulge, L5-S1 disc herniation, or L5-S1 disc protrusion, and all the associated symptoms like back pain, leg pain, sciatica, radiculopathy, numbness, tingling, stiffness, limited mobility, chiropractic can help. In fact, many cases can be helped with chiropractic. Now, that's the short answer. Okay, now go watch all my other videos to see how chiropractic can help. Now, when is surgery required? Because surgery sometimes is required. Our main objective is to get people out of pain, get them functioning normally in their regular life again, and avoid surgery. There are some percentages of cases, usually 2, 3, 4% of cases that may require surgery, and the symptoms or the conditions that I would recommend them to go see their doctor for a surgical consult will be this. First of all the red flags, Caudy-Quina syndrome symptoms, the shooting pain or weakness down both legs, that's not normal, the numbness or the it's called saddle anesthesia or saddle paresthesia, the numbness or the prickly or tingling sensation around the buttock area, around the anus area, around the saddle area of your inner thighs and buttock, that's not normal as well. These are Caudy-Quina syndrome symptoms that require immediate surgical consultation or a visit to the ER. Also, Caudy-Quina syndrome symptoms are loss of bladder function or bowel function or urinary incontinence or dripping, right? So leakage. These are not normal circumstances. That means there's a major disc blowout that's affecting the nerves that goes to the sacral organs and the tissues around the buttock area that need a medical attention immediately. So these are surgical requirements, okay? So barring that, right, sometimes people need surgery. Outside of that, because the problem's been just so chronic, 2, 3, 4, 5 years, and hasn't changed. That happens sometimes. Or in the short term, let's say 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 weeks, there's been zero change in pain symptoms. Maybe surgery might be required in that situation. Or they've had a severe neurologic compromise to their muscles, shrinkage of their muscles or atrophy in their legs, or a foot drop that's not resolved, or the big toe has lost its strength and it hasn't resolved. These are situations that require possibly a surgical consultation, or you know they have a very low tolerance to standing for a long time, like 2, 3 minutes, and they begin to fatigue, can't stand on their legs anymore. So chronicity of symptoms and neurologic deficits, and of course severe symptoms associated with Caudy-Quina, those are always things that may be required or consideration for surgery. Barring that, outside of those things, chiropractic can help 90-95% of cases or patients with disc injuries or disc herniations or disc bulges. In fact, we've helped many, many patients in our office using corrective chiropractic care. If you want to see how we do that, go watch some of the videos on my channel. Just look, go to my channel page, search L405 disc bulge, and you'll see a whole bunch of exercise videos and also corrective videos in terms of how we correct spines that have disc injuries. And if you like this series of Ask Dr. Walter Salubro, you want your question answered, just comment below, ask your question, or go ahead and check the rest of the videos right over here to catch some of the past episodes of Ask Dr. Walter Salubro, right there.